Welcome, Loxon here, and you're here in my basement. And I've got this Hoover scrub vacuum thing that I'm gonna be working on. I can't find this stuff nowhere for it, like the bristles. So I got some parts to make me some new ones. Let's check these out. Sorry about the mess. So here's the top of my bristle. As you see, I got these quick connects. I've searched and searched and searched online, but they're 9/16. So I found these bad boys. I'll slide right on. Everything's gonna sit a little higher than it should because I'm not cutting these down, but those are gonna go on. And I probably could have gone with something a little smaller, but I'm gonna weld those on there and I can put whatever the heck I want to these things. I actually made a mark for total height that I want to give, and I'll probably actually cut them down if I can and then weld them on. That way I can have these things right about here. Yeah, that sounds good. That's what I might do. I'm gonna try doing that real quick. All right, so I'm using my trusty table saw here and a grinder to cut these bad boys down. I forgot to make a mark, so I'll be right back. All right, so that's about to be my height. I'm gonna cut just a little high, maybe just a little low. I'm gonna cut that. Okay, nothing seems on fire yet. We're good so far down in my wood shop. Let's go see if the thing actually fits. It's not too bad. Woo! A little hot. Little hot, ooh, little hot. Hit. All right, so, there you go. Yeah, I'll just have to straighten that out. Ooh, hot, I run into stuff, hot. All right, so now those are cut. Now on to the flattening process. All right, flattening process. We're not plugged in. There we go, that's good. That's good. These are hot though. Whew, all right, let's talk about this next step. You can't even see me, there you go. Let's go to the next step, which is taking these galvanized pieces and grinding the galvanized off so I can weld onto it. Let's go get them. So here are the pieces that they say they're galvanized. So I have to grind down whatever I'm gonna weld onto, like here and there, to weld onto it. I'm actually going to have to not do what I wanted. I think this is gonna really stink. I should have got the ones that fit better. Ooh, hot, ow, oh, hot, woo, woo, those are so hot. All right, so I just got it tack welded just a little bit. So I'm gonna put them on our machine here and then make sure that they're level. So once it goes like this, it turns. And I got a little straightening to do. This is how I'm gonna find out what's going on. I'm gonna take this marker, just almost like balancing a dry shaft. I'm gonna turn it on. All right, so I tack welded it on. I came down here, I tapped it real quick.
My issue before was I didn't make a big enough tack. Yeah, one more to go. I can't work like this. It's too cramped down here. All right, I think this should be cooled enough. I mean, it's still pretty freaking warm. Rinsing them off. Now I'm getting soaked because I'm rinsing them off. What is that? Here we go. We got piece one. I know the welding looks like turd. And piece two. Again, I know the welding looks like turd. There's some ice in here. Here it goes. Now it dropped down. I'm like, why is it not dropping down? Well, not bad. They look pretty decent for height. I think I'm doing okay. This one's a little wobbly. This way. So, yeah, it looks like a CD would be a great size for this. I'm going to transfer it onto this bad boy. And then I have a whole bunch of them. So I'm gonna go cut some of this. Okay, so I got this big old thing. I just took this ring off. And I'm just gonna line these up and I'm gonna trace these like so. Okay, so this is a nice brush and I work outside. I frame houses right now. I get really muddy. So instead of making all these into bristles like I thought I was going to, I'm only going to start with two so I can get my project on its way. But I'm going to keep the other two on the side in case I need to make them later. And the other half of it, I'm going to turn into boot scrubbers. Not in this video. There we go. 6-inch circles or whatever a disc is. I don't know, 5.5, whatever. They're not six. But that's what I'm using because that's what's going to work. I'm going to take it over to my bandsaw and I'm going to cut it down like this so I can see where I'm cutting, and then I'll slowly work these around. It's not working. It's not those. Usually it's that stuff. I got myself good. Dusty in here. So this is what I got. This one kind of got cut short. I could have used some of that. Wait, what's that one? Yeah, right there. See? Cut short. This one's fine. I was going to round it all nice smooth. I don't think I need to. It'll be fine just the way it is. It's not that many RPMs. Okay. That's fine. All right. Now I got all these things to make sure that they fit. That one's a no-go. That one's kind of a no-go. That one fits. That one fits. All right then. All right, so here's that part. You didn't get to see me screwing it on. I can't find all my screws, so I only did two. I think that'd be okay to give it a shot.
turned out pretty good. I mean, I could have made it look better by rounding it all out, but I feel like I would have lost a lot of the brushes. So it is what it is right now. Let's look at it. All right, so the worst part is that these don't actually click in. It's like the worst part, but they do go in like they're supposed to. They sit really high, but I got this other flat scrubber right here that will sit on a smaller piece of wood, and I could scrub that, but this is going to be like a dry cleaning process. Here we go! Let's all scrub it! Alright, so here we are in my kid's room. Let me just show you what I mean. See this mess? Oh, she stands, not that bad. But over here, I did like a 4x6 square with my drill. And it took 4 hours for a 4x square. Now that it's all dry, I'm hoping these bristles will help scrub this dark stuff off. If not, that's why I have that other piece, because I know it cleans it. And I'll just have to keep on going and keep on going, you know what I mean? So I'm gonna flip this camera around and we're gonna watch this thing turn all about. All right, I'm gonna note to self that this thing does go crazy. Like, I feel like I gotta hold it down. Because this is gonna happen. I can't go backwards. I can't go backwards. What happened? What happened? What's going on? This ain't working. Okay, so the biggest issue I got going on is they fall off and it's a lot of balance and they're coming out everywhere. Oh well. But what I'm doing down on the floor is I'm going to try to hold it down on the ground so they don't pop off. When I actually go to do this, I'll use like some sticky tack or something to keep them in. I don't know what yet. It's not as strong as I thought it was gonna be. And I'm sure if they weren't so tall, it would be better. It looks like it's doing something though. I'm gonna focus on this one square and see what we got. The splines are going everywhere. It's drawing more amperages than I thought it would. It's like wearing down. That can't be good. That's all I got is needles on the ground.
I thought it had more amperage than this. My drill was spinning it faster than that. But little balance issues because those bricks are so high up. And all I'm doing is losing bristles in it right now. I don't know. I'll make some flat plates for the other stuff I showed you earlier. That'd be a part two. But they are working. You can see the dirt on them. They are working. Just every single bristle is falling out. So next time, Loxton out.